It is Monday, March 23rd. I always have to check the calendar. And this is my 2-week grocery haul, which I'm hoping I'll be able to stretch it to actually a month grocery haul. With everything we already had, you know, we're not completely out of food. Plus what I picked up at the Indiana Hope Center, which I will insert that footage here.
So this is what we picked up at the Hope store. And I'm feeling a lot more settled now that I got these like staples that I'm not sure will be available at Walmart or any of the other grocery stores. So I'll just start at this end and work my way down. I picked up some candy, you know, some chocolate. You gotta have a little chocolate during these times. So I picked up some of these Bark Thins, 2 bags of those, 2 bags of these organic gummy bears. Got some of this Powerade. Scott really likes Powerade, and this is blackberry flavored, so I got 2 of those. For those of you who don't know, the Hope Center is like a food store that, it's like a food thrift store for food. It's food that other stores like have overstocked, and the Hope Center is able to buy this stuff or get donations, and then they resell it at a really reduced price. The only thing about the Hope store is that you have to watch expiration dates. Sometimes things are really out of date, and if they're really out of date, I don't buy them. I got 2 of these bags of chips. They're called Hint of Hatch. So they've got a little bit of a spiciness to them, I think. But I was planning on making nachos one night for dinner, and so that's why we went ahead and picked those up. I got a big thing of French's mustard, and this is not expired, and so that's nice to have. I got 4 of these Birch Benders pancake and waffle mix. The classic recipe does not have milk in it, and I've had the Birch Benders before, and it's really, really good pancake mix. So it's nice to have this in stock. I won't have to use my flour to make pancakes with, or waffles, and flour is one of the things I'm having a hard time finding. So I got 2 of these shelf stable Coffee Mate creamers just to keep in the cupboard in case we can't find Scott and Travis's coffee creamer when I go shopping on Monday. They did have napkins and paper towels there, and they had a limit of 1 each. And I think it's a really good idea to put limits on things, because we all know what's been happening. They did also have toilet paper, but we didn't need it, so I didn't get any. Got 2 of these apple cinnamon oatmeal little packets. Olivia likes to eat oatmeal on occasion. These are shelf stable, and so we can hang on to these for a while and have it if we need it. One of the things I was really worried about, because I was running low on and I didn't know if I'd find it in my regular grocery stores, was rice and pasta. They had a ton of rice of every kind. They had brown rice, white rice, they had mixed wild rice, they had all kinds of rice, tons of it. So I didn't feel bad about buying 3 containers of this brown basmati rice. So now I feel better inside my soul because we have rice, plenty of rice for the family. And I did buy quite a bit of pasta. They had tons of pasta there, tons. And so I bought several bags, and then I told Scott, I said, don't let me buy any more pasta, because it's one of those things where we eat a lot of pasta. It's shelf stable, it lasts a really long time, and it just makes me feel more comfortable inside of my soul that we have these in the pantry. So I got a box of elbow macaroni and 2 boxes of this rotini. And then on down the aisle, I saw they had this Wacky Mac, so I got 2 of those. And then I saw this huge 5-pound bag of the rotini. And when I put this in my cart, that's when I told Scott, I don't need any more, because it's really easy to get into this hoarding mentality because you're of the uncertainty of everything. So we have plenty of pasta. This will last us 6 weeks at least. And that's if we ate pasta every other day. I got some of these pinto beans. I had beans and rice on my schedule for a meal. So I saw they had pinto beans there, so I picked those up. And then Scott just likes to eat beans on occasion, so we got a couple extra cans of pinto beans. And then he wanted to try the spicy black beans. He only got one of those. And then they had this organic quinoa in the little individual pouches. I think it's like microwavable. And yeah, minute. And so this would make a nice side dish for a lunch for Olivia or whoever wants it. And then because we spent $25, we spent more than $25, they were giving out these for free. We got five of them for free. They're just shampoo and conditioner. Travis will probably use these. And even though it's men's, Libby and I could use them too. Scott doesn't like shampoo that has conditioner in it, so he probably won't use them. But that's my little haul from the Hope Center. I'm just going to tag this on to my regular grocery haul. So I'll see you guys in a couple of days. This is Saturday. I'm going to go shopping on Monday.
And everything I picked up today, I'm hoping that I won't have to go back into town at least for 3 weeks. I know I'll probably have to maybe put in a small order, pickup order for like bread and milk and eggs and that kind of thing, with, you know, before the month is up, and fresh produce. But I'm really trying to not go out any more than I absolutely have to. I tried to be more mindful in my shopping today, not only for what we will be using and needing, but also for what other people might be needing. I think the reason why we're having empty store shelves is because people are they're panicking and they're being too selfish and they're not thinking of their neighbor. So I was really trying to be mindful, not only of what we really needed and will be using in the next 2 to 3 weeks, but also what other people might need. If it was the last thing on the shelf, I didn't take it unless I absolutely needed it. And I think if more people did that, then the shelves wouldn't be so bare. This was a bit of a different type of a shopping experience for me for a number of reasons. I think a lot of people are doing the order online pickup service so they don't have to go into the stores. And so I was not able to get a slot for Walmart, a time slot, until later in the early afternoon, which I try to go in the morning, and I couldn't get a slot at all at Kroger. So I ended up having to go into Kroger. Because I couldn't get a slot at Walmart till later in the afternoon, I kind of did my shopping backwards today. I went to Aldi first, then I went over to Kroger, and then I went to Walmart and picked up my online order. For the most part, I was able to find everything I needed except for flour. I couldn't find flour anywhere. And as you saw in my Indiana Hope haul, I was able to find pasta and rice there, so I didn't even worry about getting that today at Walmart or Aldi or Kroger. I did have to pick up a few things different than I ordinarily purchase, and the good thing about going into Kroger this time was I was able to find a few dairy-free items that I didn't even know existed, and you'll see that in that part of my haul. The only thing that was really aggravating about my trip today is that the reason I went into Walmart in the first place is because I needed to pick up my prescription. And when I called the prescription in, they said it would be available today. I went in to pick it up and it's not there. They said it will be in tomorrow, which that really kind of bothers me because now I have to make another special trip and it's my thyroid medication, so I really do need it. I don't know if I can even wait a week. So I'll probably have to go back into town tomorrow, which is very aggravating to me. I will definitely call them before I go in to see if it's there. All right, my arm is about to fall off from holding this camera up in the air, so let me turn this camera around and show you what I picked up from Walmart.
So this is what I picked up from Walmart. And of the three stores, Walmart, Aldi, and Kroger, Walmart's shelves were the barest. and they had the least offer. But that's okay, I was able to find everything I needed. When I went in to get my prescription that wasn't there, I picked up some yarn. I figure if I have to not go to my job, which right now I'm still on schedule to go to work, but if not, I'll have some yarn to work on a crochet project. Olivia needed some more paint, so I got her burnt umber and red apple. Picked up some more of this Dove dry spray and a perspirant for me. I really like this stuff. And this time I'm trying the lavender fresh scent. I picked up two of these things of laundry detergent, the tiny little bags. My stuff I normally buy, the Foca, they were completely out of, so I just went ahead and got two of these. Oh, the other thing that was different at Walmart for the online purchases was they had a limit of two. You couldn't buy more than two of anything, which is fine. I think that's kind of sensible. It doesn't affect us too much. I'm sure it affects those with a much larger family, but it doesn't really affect us that much. When I went into the store, I saw this adorable sloth blanket, and I thought it was so cute. And it was springy with the spring flowers, and it was definitely an impulse buy, but it was only $2, and so I picked that up. Now this is actually because my birthday is coming up. My birthday is April 2nd, and I won't be back into town before my birthday. Well, at least to go get my prescription, other than that. And Amazon is not shipping anything other than medical supplies right now. So I couldn't just very well give a link to my husband of what I wanted for my birthday and have him order it. So I just decided I wanted this Pioneer Woman electric kettle, and it's super pretty and I love it. And so yeah, it's a birthday present for me. I picked up a new shower liner. The one that I have in my shower is getting cruddy, so I need to take this new one and put it up, throw the old one away. Picked up some more air freshener. This is the Whispering Woods scent. Picked up some steel wool soap pads and some of the laundry additive stuff that I like to put in the laundry. I picked up these baby wipes because I'm going to keep these in my car, and actually I already opened them and used them to wipe my hands off and to wipe the steering wheel off. Every time I get out of the car and have to touch a shopping cart or whatever, when I get back in the car, I will use these. They didn't have any like antibacterial wipes at all, but they did have baby wipes. So I got that for that reason. Picked up some more allergy medicine for Scott. I picked up this 2-pack of face wipes. Olivia said she needed some, and I didn't know if Travis needed any, so I went ahead and just got the 2-pack. If he doesn't need them, then Olivia will have plenty to last for at least a month or more. I got 2 cans of this beefy mushroom soup, 1 thing of Hormel chili with no beans, and 1 thing of nacho cheese sauce. 1 thing that Walmart was very low on were their canned goods, so I didn't get very many. I got 2 loaves of bread. Like I said, they had a limit of 2, so I got 2 loaves of bread. I got 2 of these Kind bars for Scott to take in his lunch, and I got some baking soda, and I thought this was like a regular size box of baking soda, but it's this tiny little baby size, but that's okay. I picked up some more Earth Balance dairy-free spread for Olivia and I. Got 2 of the barbecue flavor and 1 of the salt and pepper of the pork rinds for the family. I got that thing of chips for Travis for his lunch. I got 2 bunches of green onions just to use for recipes. 2 bunches of very green organic bananas. I got 2 boxes of pie crust. 1 is for my birthday. I want a coconut cream pie instead of cake. So that's what that 1 is for. And then the other is for a recipe that I'm going to do. got some bird seed for my parakeet and my finch. Got some pink lady apples, a box of cereal for Travis. Got some of these little cherub tomatoes. Some coffee for the guys. This is something different I got this time. They did not have the kind I normally get the guys, so I got them two of the Dove and then one of the Almond Joy coffee creamers. I got coconut milk to make my coconut cream pie for my birthday. Got two more things of grape juice concentrate. I bought two a couple weeks ago, so I got two more of those. This was like the only frozen foods they had, really, were some turkey meatballs. Thankfully, I got some of those. And then Mountain Dew for Travis. That is everything I got from Walmart. I'll get this stuff put away and show you what I got from Kroger. So this is everything I picked up from Kroger. I got some dairy-free macaroni and cheese mix just to keep in the pantry. Got two of our organic chocolate chips. I ended up getting Travis milk at Kroger because when I was at Aldi, I thought about getting him milk, and then I was like, oh, I think he has enough. And then when I got to Kroger, I got to double guessing myself, thinking, oh, maybe he doesn't have enough. That's my fault because I should have checked before I left. But anyway, I just picked him up one of the organic 1% milk just for him. I got two of my Silk dairy-free soy coffee creamers and one of the French vanilla nut pods. Like I said, I had to go into the store, and when I was in there, I saw they had this, which is a plant-based cream cheese alternative, and there's no soy in it either. So if you're sensitive to soy or not wanting to get too much soy in your diet, this is an option. I don't know if it's any good, but I bought one just to try. I picked up some more of my ginger dark chocolate, which is really tasty. This is another thing I saw that I didn't know existed, and this is plant butter with avocado oil, and it's good for cooking, baking, and spreading. So if Olivia wants to make some chocolate chip cookies, or any kind of cookies, she can use this butter, and the cookies should turn out right, because if you just use margarine or a spreadable butter like this, the cookies, they don't puff up, they spread out and get flat, which they still taste good, but they just don't, the texture's not quite right. I picked up some more of our avocado oil spreadable butter, got some more cereal, Cocoa Crispy Rice and Blueberry Wheatfuls. Got two cans of low sodium chicken broth. Another thing that I couldn't find in any of the stores was pizza sauce. So I went ahead and just got this organic Bertolli olive oil and basil, and we can use this to make homemade pizza. I got some freezer waffles, some multigrain, and some blueberry. Olivia loves freezer waffles. We got some more of our dairy-free cheese, American slices, one mozzarella, and two cheddar. And then I got some organic Granny Smith apples. I was probably gonna use that to bake with. I'm not sure what, but I don't know, something. So that's everything I got from Kroger. I'll get this stuff put away and show you what I got from Aldi. This is everything I picked up from Aldi. Now, Aldi was the one store that had limits on everything. You could not buy more than three of one thing in every department. They also had signs up everywhere that reminded us of social distancing and not being more than 6 feet apart, together. And I tell you what, that was not easy.
It was hard to stay 6 feet apart from people when there was quite a few people in the store, but I did my best. And anytime I got too close, I would kind of like hold my breath until I got past the people. But yeah, at least they were reminding people that they needed to stay 6 feet apart. But yeah, that was challenging.
Okay, so this is what I picked up. I got three packs of these turkey sausages snack sticks for Scott. I got one of these bagel skinny packs for Olivia and I. I got three of the everything bagels for Travis. They did not have any of the oatmeal bread that I've been getting, so I got two of these artisan loaves for Scott and I. Oh, I got two dozen organic eggs. I can get eggs from work, so I wasn't too worried about that, but I just wanted to get two dozen for now. I got some of this trail mix for Scott's lunch, one package of oyster crackers. I got three of my freeze-dried fruits that I've really been enjoying. I got one strawberry. I decided to try the apple this time. And then I got one mango. I didn't know if I could get like three mango, three apple, three strawberry, or if it meant three of, you know, of the freeze-dried fruits. So I just decided to get one of each. I got some restaurant style tortilla chips. I got two bags of potato chips, one barbecue and one wavy. I got three of the fizzy waters for Scott. I got one jar of peanut butter. I got three spices that we were needing, paprika, cumin, and chili powder. This is for my homemade taco seasoning. Got some pepperoni for pizzas. I got some extra virgin olive oil. They did not have my regular organic pasta sauce. That's my favorite. And they had very little of this as well, so I just got two, and that should be a plenty. I think we have one jar of the organic in the cupboard, so we may use this for pizza rather than that Bertolli that I bought for pizza. We might use this instead. They did not have any butter except for margarine, and then they had this Irish butter, and Scott and Travis really enjoy real butter. They don't like margarine. So I went ahead and just got two of these Irish butters. They're not even a pound each. They're only 8 ounces. So between the two of them, that's a pound. And I usually buy 1 pound of butter every 2 weeks. So hopefully that will last. I got one mozzarella cheese and one Colby Jack cheese for cooking with. I got some unsweetened applesauce. Normally I only buy organic applesauce, but they did not have any organic applesauce anywhere. So I just went ahead and went with this. I like to use this in my baking instead of oil. I got one thing of half and half for Scott's coffee. I got one frozen pizza for Travis for Sundays usually. I got one organic ketchup, 2 cans of mandarin oranges, 2 cans of French style green beans, 3 bags of frozen broccoli, some maple syrup. We were completely out of maple syrup. I got one of these crispy circles. This is for dinner tonight. It's like the tater tot tops, and they did not have any at Walmart. So I got these at Aldi. I probably should have got 2 bags, but I just, like I said, I was trying to be mindful of others, so I just got one. I got 2 bags of the chicken strips. These are for our dinner tonight, as well as one of these, what are these? Sweet Asian wings. So these three are for dinner tonight, as well as this potato tots. The popcorn chicken is for Olivia's lunches, as well as I got another bag of the sweet Asian chicken. I got some more of this quinoa bowls for Olivia for lunches. Got one Southwestern style and one Mediterranean. Got 2 English cucumbers. I got 1 bag of the cherry berry blend frozen fruit. This is another thing I like to buy organic when I can, but they didn't have any, so I had to go with the regular. Got some cocktail sausages. I was planning on making beans and rice and cornbread one night for dinner, and I like to put these little sausages in it. Got some hard salami for sandwiches. Got 2 of these little ham steaks for 2 different meals that I'm planning. I got a bag of potatoes. It's another thing I like to get organic when I can, but I couldn't this time. I got one thing of paper towels. I didn't get any toilet paper. I couldn't find any toilet paper anywhere for one thing, and thankfully we didn't need any anyway, so I didn't get any. I got two things of paper plates, a thing of garbage bags, and some Cascade for our dishwasher. That is everything I picked up from Aldi.
So that is my end of March grocery haul, and like I said, I'm going to try to make this food stretch as far as I can and try to stay out of the grocery stores for at least the next 3 weeks, if at all possible. And I'm hoping we have enough to carry us through that. I think we will. I hope all of you are doing well and that you're staying healthy. Everyone in our family is healthy, and so far Scott, Travis, and I still have our jobs, so that's a lot to be thankful for. Right now our internet is down on this day, on the 23rd, when I'm recording this. I do plan to upload this video on the 25th, which is Wednesday, if we have our internet back. If you get this later than that, that's why. It's like the perfect time for us to not have internet when everyone has to stay home. Oh well, such is life. All right, friends, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a thumbs up, and we will talk to you later. Bye-bye. There's one other thing I wanted to mention, is that, you know how they say, you know, social distancing, cough into your elbow, don't touch your face, wash your hands a lot, etc., etc. Has anyone else experienced this? You know you're not supposed to touch your face, so every 5 minutes your face itches. My face itches, my eyes itch, my nose itches. And then I'm like, making all these faces so I don't touch my face. Oh my word, I'll be so glad when this is all over with. Anyway, I wanted to share that. I forgot. So this is a little PS to my video. So we'll talk to you later. Bye.